stop staring at me. Hey, it's kind of weird that you're, you know, staring at me like this. Can you please just, like, look somewhere else? Because it's kind of getting uncomfortable right now.
Oh, yeah, no problem. It's no problem. I got you.
Cool? All right. To start this haircut off, I'm gonna use my duck clips pinning the hair up so I could get a clear visual on my fade. To start this haircut off, I'm gonna take the size down to a number 3 closed, all right? Number 3 closed is an actual 3. To me, this is a great length to take hair to when it comes to doing a ball fade.
Other a little bit more, and I think it's a healthy thing. I listen to all sorts of people, comedians.
All right, I gotta stop this video real quick. You see the hard work, the dedication, the motivation. He's filming right here. We're getting it in. You see it. It's hard work. The dedication is there. We're all filming. Okay, let me get back to what I'm doing right now. First of all, let me give a shout out to George right here. Follow him. The link will be right here. And then follow Memo right here because the link will definitely be somewhere right here. So make sure you guys follow these two. And I'm gonna just get back to what I'm doing because my client is waiting on me over here. But follow these guys. The link will be somewhere right here.
iHeartRadio does one-on-one with Flo Rida. Getting some insight into his songwriting and recording process.
I like it to be ball organic. Sometimes I might be in the...
All right, so what you guys want to do right now is set in your bald line. I'm setting my bald line a little bit under the point of my client's lineup. Next, I'm gonna use my Andes Pro Lithium Shaver just to get the bottom half razor bald. Now, you don't wanna go all the way up to the line because all you're doing is creating another transition so it could really be smooth at the bottom. Using my Oster's Fast Feeds with the lever open, go up about an inch. with the one guard open, in that same way I set the lever closed, go up about an inch. Using the two guard open, I'm not necessarily setting in a guideline. I'm just taking off a little bit of bulk from the top. Dropping back down to the one guard open, I'm cleaning up that area between the one and the two using my flick out technique. Closing the lever on the one guard, just soften up that middle line in a flick out motion. Now with the zero guard closed and a flick out motion, you're able to take out that middle line. With the lever closed in a flick out motion, flick out the bottom line. Now make sure that you adjust as you go up. Don't just stay with the lever closed, you know, the entire time. Make sure you adjust. I'm taking out my clips just to saturate my client's hair with water. Right now I'm doing some shear work. I'm just gonna go up take off about an inch, and set my guidelines. Right now I'm just getting all the hair out, and I'm gonna put some Johnny B mold in my client's hair. We also sell that at the shop. It's a great product for curls. Using my Paul Mitchell blow dryer, I got this curl nozzle on there, and I'm just gonna be basically blow drying my client's hair, making sure that I don't disrupt the curl. And this nozzle that I have on is perfect for that. YouTube, this is The Cut. And if you like it, please give it a thumbs up. If you're new to my channel, please hit that subscribe button. Make sure you guys hit that notification bell at the bottom next to the subscribe button so you guys will be notified when I drop videos. Make sure you guys follow me on Instagram and Snapchat. My Instagram is 360 Jeezy and my Snapchat is Jeezy360. But it's your boy 360 Jeezy, and I'm out of here. Cheers.